لا أملك إلا نفسي وأخي. The only thing is me and Harun. Musa and Harun. He put 1,000. وقت صفة. Come as one mind. وقد أفلح إيه؟ وقد أفلح اليوم من استعلى. And today is the day of success. 1,000 throwing their sticks and their robes and become. It was a mess. I mean, can you imagine? You are in a place that you see one snake, and how do you feel? You feel very uncomfortable. Subhanallah. Imagine 1,000 snakes running around. What happened to the people? Because they have gathered all of Egypt at that time. When yuhshar al-nas duha, look at the scene. I just want to give you the scene. And all of that, and the Sahara came, and they said, "Ya Fir'aun, wa inna lana la ajran." We are the one that we will have something, you know, the reward we're looking for. We came from all over Egypt for this purpose. Na'am, wa innakum la min al-muqarrabin. You are gonna be closer to me, very close to me. And even all of that happening, and then when they dropped their sticks and their robes. Become, it was a chaos. It was a miserable thing. He was running around, you know, these snakes running around, running after people. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told Musa, وَأَلْقِ مَا فِي يَمِينِكَ. Just throw what is in your right hand. Because Sayyidina Musa was mesmerized also with this whole scene. 1,000 snakes. You throw your snake, what's your snake is going to do? تَلْقَفُ مَا يَخْفِكُونَ. It was a lie. And that snake turned to be a huge snake and start swallowing all the snakes around. فَخَرَّ السَّحَرَةُ سَاجِدِينَ. Can you imagine? In the beginning of the day, Ibn Kathir يقول, in the beginning of the day, they were magicians. In the middle of the day, they were believers. In the end of the day, they were martyrs. In the beginning of the day, they were magicians. In the middle of the day, they were believers. They all made sujood. They said, there's no way. There's no way. This is a work of a human being. It has to be God. And then Fir'aun got very upset and he said, لَا قَطِعَنَّ أَرْدِيَكُمْ وَأَرْجُلَكُمْ مِنْ خِلَافِ. I will cut your right arm and left leg. Or I'm going to cut your left leg and right arm. Or the opposite. وَلَأُصَلِّمَنَّكُمْ فِي جُذُوعِ النَّخْلِ. And I will crucify you all. قَالُوا فَقْضِ مَا أَنْتَ قَضِ. Do whatever you want to do. إِنَّمَا تَقْضِي هَذِهِ الْحَيَاةِ الدُّنْيَا. إِنَّا آمَنَّا بِرَبِّنَا لِيَغْفِرْ لَنَا خَطَايَانَا. What kind of belief is this? Then يقول الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم أثبت الناس إيمانا أبا بكر. The most, you know, steadfast and their faith is Abu Bakr wa Sahara Fir'aun. Because the Sahara could have said, oh, you know, Fir'aun, sorry, you were just joking about it. You know, and then run away and then do whatever you want to do. No, they were there sitting in front of the Fir'aun and they said, no, we believe. And he killed, as was mentioned in the seerah of Musa alayhi salam, that he killed all of them. 1,000 were killed that day, and crucified. And they did not reject one thing that they believed in. We all read Surah Humazah. وَيْلٌ لِكُلِّ هُمَزَةٍ لُمَزَةٍ أَلَّذِي جَمَعَ مَالًا وَعَدَّدًا يَحْسَبُ أَنَّ مَالَهُ أَخْلَدًا كَلَّا لَيُنْبَذَنَّ فِي الْحُطَمَةِ وَمَا أَدْرَاكَ مَا الْحُطَمَةِ نَارُ اللَّهِ الْمُوْقَدَةِ الَّتِي تَطَّلِعُ عَلَى الأفئدة. So the fire, when it starts attacking people in hellfire, it does not attack the face or the body first. It attacks the heart. التي تطلع على الأفئدة إنها عليهم مؤصدة في عمد ممددة. So the heart is the first thing that will be burned. Because the heart is the place either for tranquility or for rejection. يقول الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم تعرض الذنوب على القلوب، تعرض الذنوب على القلوب عودا عودا. He said, bad deeds will come, you know, in pieces to the, toward the heart. A piece by piece. فأي قلب مشربها, in any heart that will start, you know, drinking it and taking it in and accept that bad deed, نكدت فيه نكتة سوداء. There will be a black spot on the heart. وأي قلب أنكرها, and the heart that rejected, it will be, there will be a white dot on the heart. حتى تكون القلوب إلى قلبين. The heart will be two kind of hearts. قلب أبيض مثل الصفر. A heart so clear, like a pearl, like those, you know, rocks that is so white, you know. And then he said, لا تضره فتنة. Nothing will harm him. وقلب أسود مربادا كالكوز مكخية. And a heart so black, so dark, like a container flipped upside down. Why the container flipped upside down? If you try to put anything in that container, it will not accept anymore. Anything. لا يعرف معروفا ولا ينكر منكرا. Does not know anything good and does not forbid evil. That's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told about Bani Israel when he said, وَأُشْرِبُوا فِي قُلُوبِهُمُ الْعِجْلَ بِكُفْرِهِمْ. The kufr, it's not just say, I reject. No, he said, أُشْرِبُوا. أُشْرِبُوا, when you are so, you know, watered, you know, like when you put a sponge in the water and it takes all the water in, he said, this is exactly how they accepted kufr. It is all over their body, not only the heart. As if someone was drinking it and filled his body with it. That's why they rejected subhanAllah the truth. Every time Sayyidina Musa, wallahi akhwana qissat Musa alayhi salam, ajeeba yani, it is wonderful when you read it and you see how much pain he went through with Bani Israel. How much pain. Every ayah and after ayah after ayah. And these people, I'm never, you know, accepting that. So what wounds the hearts? Number one, al-ghafla an Allah. Be heedless about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Heedless. Not even, you know, you hear these people, you hear sometimes people say, well, you know what, this guy and this brother, he is really good. He does not cheat. He does not lie. He's a very nice guy. Or she is a very nice sister. But what? They don't pray. They don't do any ibadah to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But they're good. Their heart is good. And sometimes he asks one of them, he says, Ya akhi, why don't you pray? He said, Ya akhi, iman fil qalb. He said, iman is in the heart. So don't talk to me. I know myself. And we tell them, this is one of the robes, say, habail al-shaytan, you know, one of the robes of shaytan. That he pulls you wet. The whole thing they do is what? Living and dying. They live and they die. Sufyan al-Thawri was one of them. Yeah, Sufyan al-Thawri. One of the great mufassirin of the Quran. He used to be young. When he was young, he used to go for hunting. Grab whatever it is, you know, from the hunting. Go back at the end of the day. And cook it and eat it and sleep. Every day, that was his. That was his life. He was rich. He doesn't need to work. So one day he was coming back from the hunting, an old man stopped him. And he told him, أَلِهَذَا خُلِقْتْ أَمْ بِهَذَا أُمِرْتْ. He said, Is this what you were created for? Or is this what you have been ordered to do in your life? Allah created you to do this? Just to go hunting and come back? And how many people you see in your life? I'm talking about